Ever tried estimating AWS costs and felt completely lost? Sure, there is the AWS pricing calculator, but let's be real. Unless you're a FinOps expert, it feels like solving a puzzle blindfolded. Even for something simple like a serverless app, you have to provide a lot of details, like expected request counts, memory configurations, storage requirements, and that's just the beginning. But what if we could use AI to help? Of course, we can't just rely on AI models because they don't know the pricing differences across different AWS regions or features.
It's true. Like, you can try to ask an LLM, like a foundation model. It will try to answer the best of its knowledge, but it will not be very reliable. But we have tools to actually estimate the cost that are very amazing. For example, InfraCost is an open source tool, and it can actually, directly from a Terraform file, make you an estimation of the cost of what you're going to deploy. So you can see in the demo here, we have the breakdown of all of the different services that you're going to use and the monthly cost for each per usage. So this is like very amazing.
Indeed, because most of the companies already have Terraform, right? Because they automate their infrastructure provisioning. So now, before they even, let's say, make some changes, right, they can just look at the cost and decide what changes they want to make.
Yeah. So now, if we want to use an LLM to be able to use InfraCost, we can create an agent for this. So we're going to create a Lambda function that will be able to call InfraCost. And our LLM will have access to that Lambda function and be able to do an actual accurate estimate of a cost from a Terraform file. Let's see how it works. So here we have our Lambda function where we estimate the cost of the infrastructure using InfraCost. So here we are getting the latest Terraform file from S3 bucket, and we download the latest file locally, and we run InfraCost. So basically, InfraCost takes the Terraform file as an input and then generates a text file where all of the breakdown of each services and cost is in there. And so we drop this into an S3 bucket. And this is a text file. And from here, we generated a pre-prompt and we send it along with the report. And we ask Claude 3.5 Sonnet to generate, like to make a summary of this report basically from the Terraform file. And the way we call this Lambda function is through a Lambda handler that will process the API request route. So you can have, with an agent, you can have different functions. We'll see later how it works more in detail. But when you want to process an API request, you can set the path, the route, to each of your functions. And here you can see that for the estimating tool, we call the function called the Yak Estimate tool. And we bundled everything nicely inside of a Docker container. And here's our Docker file where we actually install InfraCost along with our Lambda function. So back in Bedrock, when we create an agent, we can actually point the agent to a Lambda function. And that Lambda function for us is running onto our container, Docker container. So here's the latest image. And going back to the agent, we can also specify what we call an open API schema, where we define the routes to the Lambda function that we want to use. So in the flow of the conversation, the LLM will actually be able to choose which function it needs to use. Here, basically, if we talk about the cost, then the LLM will go through the API schema, see that we have a function related to cost, and we have a nice description that says, if you want to estimate the cost of infrastructure, use that function, and here is the API path that you need to use.
This was a lot of information. Let me make sure that I understand, so I'll try to summarize it. So first, we created a Lambda function that has access to open source tool InfraCost that can use Terraform file to estimate the cost, right? We put this inside ECR container. Then we had to create API schema that was aware about this tool that we built, right? And provide description that this tool is particularly built to estimate cost.
Yeah, this part is really important. The description needs to be in plain English because the LLM will read through this to understand what the function is actually doing.
Yeah, so when you call it in the prompt, it will understand based on the descriptions that you're asking about estimating the cost, and it will match the tool's description to your prompt, right? To your task.
Yes, exactly.
So you're asking about the cost, it goes to the API schema, then the agent understands which tool to use, right? And then it will retrieve the information from the bucket, your Terraform file, and based on this, then we'll generate a new estimate and put it into a new bucket. And then the Bedrock agent, right, the LLM, will take this information and now will summarize it in a user-friendly way and respond to you.
Yeah, because the output of InfraCost can be very verbose and it can be long. So it's always nice to have an LLM that, you know, takes the entire report and be able to like summarize it to make a like little summary of the cost estimation. Okay, now let's try this in action. We have our agent prepared, connected to our Lambda function. So let's ask it to estimate the cost of the last Terraform file that was dropped inside of the S3 bucket. And here you can see like the Terraform file that the last one we had was talking about DynamoDB. It's cutting down the cost for each services. So we have a nice breakdown. And we can see that while it was doing this, it actually dropped the text, the output from InfraCost in the S3 bucket. So let's see how it looks like. Let's open this file. And this should show us the output of InfraCost, so the entire breakdown of each services and the monthly cost for each of them.
I'm really impressed. Estimating cost can be often a time-consuming and tedious process, especially when comparing different options. What I really love about this AI agent approach is that I can now ask questions, refine requirements on the fly, and get accurate estimates within seconds.
Yeah, and we've only scratched the surface of what we can do. Here we've made ourselves our own like AI FinOps agent, but we can do a DevOps agent. Basically, we can build like a super solution architect agent.
If you want to learn more about the code, check out the GitHub repo in the descriptions. And if you enjoyed this video and want more hands-on technical content, be sure to like this video and subscribe to the AWS Developers YouTube channel.
Happy coding!